This is part 8 of rational expressions, and we're just going to continue practicing adding and subtracting rational expressions that have a common denominator. So here's one for you to try. It says add or subtract, so of course it depends if there's a plus or a minus sign between the fractions, and then simplify if possible. So in this problem it's a subtraction problem, so go ahead and put the video on pause and try it on your own first if you'd like. Okay, we're subtracting. Remember, no canceling or anything. Remember, it's like this is a big numerator and this is some other big numerator and this is a denominator. And you have to make sure the denominators are the same before you can add or subtract. So in this case, they are the same. So that means you could just write the denominator down for the new denominator and subtract the numerators. So we take the first numerator, which is 5x cubed minus 13. You could keep a parentheses around it, but it's not really necessary. And then I'm subtracting the second denominator. Now, some of you may skip this step where you put minus in parentheses, 10x squared minus 13, and you might just do the distributive property on this line by writing minus 10x squared plus 13, which is what I'm going to do on the next step. Okay? So you may have simply written this for your first step once you distributed that minus sign. Okay, now what's our next step? So we've just subtracted the numerators, but we haven't simplified the numerator. So I have to combine like terms. Let's see, the 13's canceled because I have a negative 13 and a plus 13. So I have 5x squared, 5x cubed, copied that wrong, 5x cubed minus 10x squared for my numerator, and for my denominator I have x squared minus 3x minus 2. All right, so then what's our next step? We're not allowed to cancel unless it factors and we can cancel common factors. So let's try factoring the numerator and denominator. So in the numerator, there's two terms. The only way to factor two terms is by taking out a common factor, or if it happens to be a difference of two squares, you could do that, or a difference of two cubes if you know that formula. Okay, so in this one, we first always look for a common factor, and in this case, it's 5x squared. So I can pull a 5x squared out to the front, and that leaves me x minus 2. And in the denominator, we need to factor x squared minus 3x minus 2. I'm going to guess that x minus 2 might be one of my factors as a trial factor. If it doesn't work, I'll cancel out and do it differently. All right, so this will be x times x, so it will be x squared. And 1 times negative 2 will be negative 2. And so does that give me the right middle term, though? This gives me minus 2 plus 1, so that doesn't work. So that is not the correct factorization. So even if it does factor, it's not going to cancel with x minus 2. So you could try factoring, and I don't think this one's going to factor. You could try different things. You could put the, you know, it can only be a 1 and a 2. One's got to be plus, one's going to be minus. It's not going to work. So actually, the denominator does not factor. So this would be my final answer to this problem. This is almost exactly the same problem, except I have a plus 2 in the bottom for my third term there. So let's do this problem and see what happens if that would have been a different denominator. So we were, again, are going to subtract our numerators because I have a common denominator, right? The common denominator is x squared minus 3x plus 2. Let's do this all in one step here. If I'm going to subtract that numerator, it's going to change sign, so that'll be a minus 10x squared and a plus 13. Everybody okay with that? If not, you can go back and look how I did it on the previous problem where I took two steps to get there. And then we're going to combine like terms. Again, we have a negative 13 plus 13 gone, so I've got 5x cubed minus 10x squared over x squared minus 3x plus 2. And at this point, again, we're going to try factoring. So the common factor in the numerator is 5x squared, so that's what we could take out. And in the denominator, this time, the factor is to x minus 2 times x minus 1. The difference is I need these to both be negative to get a positive 2, and this factorization does give me a negative 3x for the middle term. So if this had been the problem, like it is in this time, there's some canceling that I can do. Don't assume you are always going to be able to cancel. It really just depends. So that slight little change made a big difference in your answer. So the answer is 5x squared over x minus 1. You can't go any further. Remember, x minus 1 is a factor, and there's no x minus 1 you can cancel with in the numerator. You can't cancel the x with the x squared. So there's the answer. So two problems look almost exactly the same, but quite different when you're done. All right, here's one more problem. See if you could do this on your own. This is an addition problem, so it's slightly easier. Okay, let's see. First thing we want to check is that the denominator is the same, and if they are, we could write the denominator as the, we just write it once, and then we add the numerators. So we have 15x squared minus 4x plus 14x. And then we need to simplify that numerator by combining like terms, 15x squared plus 10x. Remember, don't ever try canceling unless it's factored. Okay, so here we go. We need to factor the numerator and the denominator. So in the numerator, you look for a common factor first, right? And the common factor here is 5x. That's the greatest common factor. So we have 5x times 3x plus 2, right? In the denominator, we want to factor that. There is no common factor, so we can't do anything by taking out a greatest common factor, but it is the difference of two squares. So that's 3x plus 2 times 3x minus 2. Okay, now can we cancel anything? Yes, how convenient. Cancel out those 3x plus 2s. So what do I have left in the numerator? Remember, if you don't see anything left in the numerator, there's at least a 1. But in this case, I have a 5x, actually. So 5x all over 3x minus 2. There you go. I think we can get one more in. See if you could do this one on your own. All right, here we go. Have a common denominator, so we can begin by writing that as the denominator. And since this is subtraction, remember we're going to subtract that entire numerator after the minus sign. So we're going to change signs when I subtract that. So I take the first numerator, 7x minus 12, and I'm going to subtract a 3x minus 6. Let's go ahead and just do the distributive property now. That'll be a minus 3x and a plus 6. If you need to take two steps or write that down, that's fine. All right, let's keep going by simplifying the numerator. So I have 7x minus 3x is 4x, and negative 12 plus 6 is minus 6. All right, and in the denominator, I'm going to factor that denominator because that would be the next step. And so I've got 4x squared plus 10x minus 24. What's the first thing? Pulling out the greatest common factor, x squared minus 5x minus 12. So it's going to take two steps to factor that denominator. And that's okay because we have to factor the numerator anyway. We could take a 2 out, and that gives me 2x minus 3. And in the denominator, we have the 2, right? And then we have to factor x squared minus 5x minus 12. So what's that going to be? Let's see, one of them has to be a 2x. I'm going to try the minus 3 and a plus 4. And that does seem to be the correct factorization. So let's see, I can cancel out the 2s. I could cancel out the 2x minus 3s. So I'm left with just a 1 in the numerator and an x plus 4 in the denominator. Remember, you don't see the 1, so if there's nothing there, don't forget to put the 1. Don't write your answer as x plus 4. The x plus 4 is in the denominator. Keep practicing.